Hello again, I'm John Terzak, and today I'm going to answer a really neat, delicious question, which is how to make Japanese-style gomae, spinach gomae. And that means spinach with a little miso and peanut sauce, traditionally. And maybe not always miso, but it's made like 10 different ways. I used to go to this one Japanese restaurant across from my first restaurant in Chicago all the time and order this because I loved it so much. And then I started making it, and then finally I decided it was time to show somebody else how to make it. So let me show you what we got here. We have some fresh spinach with the stems still left on. Couldn't find any Japanese spinach, but this will do. I'm going to take some boiling water and pour it over it. I don't want to cook this spinach to death. I'm going to wilt it to death is what I'm going to do. And then I got some ice water right next to me here, which we're going to put this in. But it's got to be a little bit foldable. But we don't want it cooked, 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 cooked. That's probably cooked enough right there. So let's get it out of the water and into the ice water. That seems painless. I'm going to make you an individual appetizer version of this and a family style version of this both. So it didn't take that long for that spinach to get cool. The few ice cubes I have in there just about melted. So let's wring the spinach out. Let's get it up on the table. Chop it slightly. Hopefully I'll have enough spinach here to do both versions that I want to show you, and I might. Okay, let's leave the spinach out a little bit. Just give it a slight chop. Enough so the pieces are easy to pick up with a fork or a set of chopsticks for that matter. Let's put this in the bowl. Doing this video on real time, there's no time elapsed anything on this. Now I have some fresh miso here, and we're going to take some of this. Make ourselves a little miso broth, keeping in mind that miso's got some salt in it. Let me taste that. This is plain chicken stock, by the way, that I put it into. It was slightly warm, so it's easier for the miso to dissolve. This could take a little bit more. You know what? Let's put all this in. I knew there was a reason why I had that much sitting there. Let's taste that. Looks like miso soup that I've been getting in Japanese restaurants all my whole life. Nice, 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 nice. Simple, easy, good flavor, you know? So, let's take a splash of this and put it on the spinach. And let's put a little pinch of of olive oil on here. Not much, just a little bit. Now let's get this mixed together. I'm going to put a little bit of pepper on this. Let me just give that a taste. I love this kind of fresh food. It's I'm going to put a splash of sesame oil on here. This dish is normally served with a sesame peanut sauce. And that's exactly what it's going to get. So let's have another taste of that. A little bit of salt. Not much. And we are ready. First, I'm going to make the appetizer version for you. And we're going to be garnishing this with green beans that I blanched and cut into small pieces. These are so good, fresh green beans, especially cut that size. There's something about that size that I really like in terms of how it feels when I'm eating it. So I'm going to try something a little bit off the cuff here. I'm going to take a little bit of this Asian salad that I have, and I'm going to use that for this version, but for the larger version, I'm not going to use the Asian salad. This is really a little bit to the left, okay? We're going to take some of that and put it on the plate. And then we are going to take some of the spinach and pack it into here. And we're going to put that on the plate over it, like so. And again, like I say, using that slaw, as long as we got this out here, let's put the one for the larger version right inside here, because that's where it's going to end up. And now back to this one. Let's put a little bit of miso broth on the plate. Let's put... try something else. Make a little hole here. Let's put some of the sesame peanut sauce right there, like that, in that hole that I just made. So we're not covering up that beautiful green spinach. And let's put a couple of little red peppers on the plate. So we got a little bit of color going here. This is not a complicated dish, but it's very tasty. And let's put some chopped scallion on here. And let's put a little bit of fresh chopped cilantro on here, not much. And let's put a few unsalted dry roasted peanuts on here. And just for fun, let's put red pepper here in the middle of this, like so. And let's put some sesame seeds on here. And I would certainly serve extra peanut sauce on the side along with this. And I will put a little splash more olive oil on top of there just for fun. Okay, there you go. So there's a nice, simple appetizer version of the gomae. Got a little bit of color, got some fun, got a few different little textures going on in there. Now, the ones I've been served in Japanese restaurants, they didn't give you that much stuff. Typically, it's the miso and the spinach and the peanut sauce and maybe some scallions and maybe a few peanuts and a few sesame seeds, but no red pepper, and it just doesn't, Asian salad underneath it. All right, so let's take a shot at a larger version of this. Let's get ourselves a clean rag here. Now, let's try a larger version of this. This is a no salad version of this. Certainly could put this in a taller container, but it'd be more likely to collapse if you did that also. Now, let's try this version here with the peanut sauce directly around it, like so. It's a sesame peanut sauce, which you have a lesson for, of course. It's in the salad section. And let's put the miso broth around it. It's kind of optional on the miso broth. I mean, I rarely was it even served with me with the miso broth around it on a plate, but I think it's kind of fun, as you can see. And I think in this case, since we got the peanut sauce around it, let's put some of these red peppers in the middle of this help the presentation a little bit. And back again, chopped cilantro. This, of course, is my version, if you want to call it that, of the Gomae scallions. Peanuts. And sesame seeds. This is cute. I like this. If somebody put this down on their coffee table in front of me with a bunch of forks and some little miniature tongs and little plates, I would go ballistic. I would say, wow. So I made both of these in real time. Did not take that long. So now, the green bean process. I'm just going to sprinkle some green beans in it. This item is often served with green beans and the spinach, or you can serve this green beans straight up alone with the peanut sauce without the spinach. Put some green beans around that one. That's kind of an optional thing, the whole green bean deal here. And let's hit this with a little splash of olive oil just for fun. You got also little dribbles of oil in there, and I think that pretty much sums up the Gomae. So let me recap this. This is fresh spinach with sesame peanut sauce with some miso broth and some garnishes, scallions and peanuts and cilantro. So get a chance to eat this. If make it, eat it. Yes, if not, and go to a Japanese restaurant, order it and try it. So good luck with it. Have fun. Thank you.